Welcome, everybody. We are the Louisiana Orchestra. Coming out tonight and doing the full house performance for you. We're going to get right at it. Ruben Hart, here we go.
Thank you. Next up, gonna mix it up a little bit. This is the Stan Kent Orchestra featured. Stan Kent Orchestra is one of the most progressive big bands in history. We're indebted to Kenton in many ways, but for playing a major role for introducing jazz in the schools. He was the guy that would play a lot of schools, play a lot of school dances, and then really was an advocate for getting jazz music in the schools, eventually in curriculum. This piece is Decoupage, composed 48 years ago. Has it really been that long? So, I remember going to record stores. Who remembers going to record stores? Okay. Yeah, so, 1976, I was in junior high school. Bought this album, waited for this album, heard about it. I don't know why I heard about it, because there wasn't any internet. But heard about this album coming. Made sure to get it. So this one was written by Hank Levy, Kenton's staff composer, included on the 1976 album, Kenton 76. Hank Levy wrote a ton of beautiful melodies. This piece is in 5-4, and clearly it's one of my all-time favorites. The whole album is fantastic. This features all the sections, but it treats the trombone section in a melodic context, which is really nice. And then soloist, Noah Payton on alto saxophone, Joshua Blanchard on trumpet. And you might notice we have three bassists this evening, which is kind of cool. So we're switching it up. Jack Moreno is gonna do some bass. We're gonna check his levels here in a minute. But we're gonna add Jack to this chart. This is Decoupage.
Yeah. details.
Thank you.
Super proud. Let's all take our mental sense of pride. Jack, would you like to run trumpets? Joey Mock on lead trombone on the trumpets. And Tamani Sego on the trumpets. Next church, another bass change. We need a bigger stage. Just saying. And a bigger house. Just saying. All right, we're going to move on. Composer Thad Jones was a member of the Count Basie Orchestra from 1954 to 1963. He's a trumpet player. And also a composer. This piece, To You, was composed by Thad Jones in 1961, and interestingly enough, recorded by the Basie Orchestra and the Duke Ellington Orchestra together on the same album, recorded at the same time, featuring Thad Jones on trumpet. In 1980, Thad Jones recorded the piece with the Danish Radio Big Band on their album called Eclipse. Our performance features Kamani Senegal on the lead lines on the trumpet, Seth Shank, trombone soloist, and Pablo Miranda Delgado is joining us on bass, double bass. This is To You. Scott Hill. For Bobby Sandoval, lead trumpet. Pablo Guerrero, Brandon Delgado, high bass. That's a nice thumping piano, Brandon on the piano, thank you very much. Now, so it's a good time. Also, thank you very much. Very much. All right. We're going to end this concert. But first, I got a few things. First of all, this is our first concert. So in your program, there's listings of when we play again in December. The jazz choir will be joining us. I think it says it on the back. I'm forgetting the date. December 3rd, I think. Somewhere around there. December 3rd? December 3rd, going once? Going twice? Yes. All right, December 3rd. Jazz choir, jazz combo, jazz orchestra. It is sure to be very exciting. We've been working, prepping some of that music, and we have some mystery pieces to bring out the next time we'll meet. Yay. Lots of folks to thank, of course. Thanks to the Jazz Orchestra. This has been one of those years where we bring out new music, they read it, they read it well. We bring out more new music, we read it, they read it well. So now there's space for improvisation, creativity, all those things that you want in an ensemble like this. So thank you all very much for your work in keeping this music present. We really share it with you. Thank you very much. Yeah. And of course, what you see, of course, on stage tonight, we're both ensembles. You know, it happens really the first week of classes. You know, we start working right away after auditions. But what you see tonight, we've been in here roughly since about 12 noon today. So the folks that have lived in this room since 12 noon, I have to thank, special thanks to Dean School of Music, Chandler Recital Hall Manager, Kristen Keelan. They spend hours preparing for our concert, as short as it is, doing live sound, recording the concert on Facebook. And also, we have to thank Jordan DiCaprio for, you know, if you look around, we've got these cool lights now. And Jordan, if you can see back in the studio backstage, there are monitors, there are control boards, you name it, which are all new to us because we used to have a couple of switches. That was it. A couple switches, couple sliders, you got lights, and there are these lights in the ceiling that no one can reach. But Jordan has done a beautiful job in relighting this hall and making it work for everybody. So thank you, Jordan. I know it's backstage. Thank you. Thank you to Zachary S. Richardson. I know he's in the crowd. Zachary is a graduate assistant here. He used to be the lead trumpet player here. Now he's back from grad school. But Zachary sets up the ensemble for us after orchestra rehearsal to make sure we're up and ready to go. And of course, to percussion instructor David Walker, he's in the back of the room. Yes, thank you. Thank you, Walker. Sully, and also Professor John Toomey, who's right over there, for doing our living session on the morning. And of course, the entire Dean School Music faculty for their support of the Jazz Orchestra. All right, last chart. So I was somewhere in the country this summer. My wife and I were driving somewhere, probably hiking or maybe to a tennis match or something, but I remember this recording of the Phil Collins Big Band in Montreux, Switzerland, and I thought, let's listen to this, check this out. So in 1998, they put together a big band. It was the second time, because they'd done it a couple years earlier, an all-star big band. And you know Phil Collins, right? Okay, so Phil Collins, vocalist, is also Phil Collins' incredible drummer. Okay, maybe you didn't know that. So they put together this amazing big band for their second performance at Montreux Jazz Festival in Switzerland, 1998. Atlantic Records producer, eventually vice president, and then moved over to Manhattan Records. Arif Mardan arranged this piece, picked up the pieces. And as you know, this is kind of a 70s concert, isn't it? Yeah, really kind of is. As you know, Pick Up the Pieces was originally done by the Average White Band, written by members saxophonist Roger Ball and guitarist Hamish Stewart in 1974. Number one song in 1975. Number one pop song. I think it was number four in England. But pretty popular piece. We played them on 45s back then. But this arrangement is pretty cool, and it features everybody. But we have some solos. Please tell me if I forgot them. But I'm going to put them in order. Valerio Federici on alto sax. Ricardo Casanova on piano. Aaron Cadivi, soprano saxophone. Joshua Blanton on trumpets. Noel Payton on alto saxophone. Jack Moreno on bass. James Wooden, baritone saxophone. Mike Murray on drums. And Peter Cochran on tenor saxophone. That's the whole sax section. It's kind of appropriate. Did I miss anyone? All right, the other thing I have to tell you about this chart is you'll see us queuing. And queuing and queuing, because it really is a solo festival. Please welcome the band for Pick Up the Pieces.
Thank you very much for being here.